Hi folks, my name's Dan Sides. I'm very proud to be the principal of Northeast Futures UTC. We are a 14 to 19 school. We're in central Newcastle and we specialise in the areas of healthcare science and digital technology. I'm very pleased to be talking to you today about a competition that we've launched and just explaining to you about the competition and hopefully encouraging you to enter. So it's called the Innovation in Assistive Technology Competition, and we are running this competition in conjunction with Northeast Futures UTC, our good friends Accenture, and the IT network Dynamo. So all together we're offering this competition for young people up to the age of 19, anyone who's in school, further education, college or sixth form can enter. Competition runs alongside an event that we're running about assistive technology and innovation in assistive technology, which is running on the 4th of March at 3 p.m. And you're welcome to come along to that event, even if you're not entering the competition. So the competition is to come up with your own idea of a new assistive technology that might improve the quality of life or improve the healthcare for older people. Now, aging isn't a disability, of course, but sometimes if we use technology in an innovative way, we can help support that quality of life. I'll just give you a couple of examples to get you thinking. So one very, very simple example would be a walking stick. So if you struggle with mobility, walking stick might make it a little bit easier for you to be mobile. So it's a piece of assistive technology. Another example, a bit more complicated, would be a smart medicine cabinet. So this is a prototype. Somebody's come up with this idea, but it's not in wide circulation. That means you can't buy it from the shop yet. But the concept of a smart medicine cabinet is around a medicine cabinet that's connected to the internet and can do things like remind patients that they need to take their prescriptions. It might even be able to identify when a prescription is starting to run out and therefore automatically order a replacement. And if the smart medicine cabinet can identify that the patient hasn't taken their prescription, then you might be able to automatically notify a close friend or a member of the family to advise that that person hasn't taken their medicine and therefore they can intervene and make sure that that medicine is taken. So that's a couple of examples. Obviously, they're real examples, so you can't use those in the competition. You need to come up with your own idea. And what we're really looking for as the judges for your idea is something that's creative. So it's a very interesting creative idea. And perhaps you're thinking outside the box. We're looking for something that's innovative. So obviously we can't have the smart medicine cabinet because someone's already come up with that idea. We're looking for a new idea. And we're also looking for real life problem solving. So we want it to be realistic. We want it to solve someone's problems in real life and make quality of life that bit better, or the healthcare offer that bit better. So it must solve a real problem. So creative, innovative, and problem solving is what we're looking for. There is a prize for our competition. You can win some of your own assistive technology. Accenture are kindly providing an Amazon Echo device and a connected Fitbit device. And there are, of course, goodie bags for people who enter as well. This is some of your own assistive technology that you can win. So I think it's a fantastic prize and hopefully that will encourage you to come up with an entry. So how do you enter? Very, very simple. You need to come up with your idea and then you need to have your pitch for your idea. So basically you just need to write about your idea, about how it's a good idea, how it's innovative, how it solves a problem. You can either write it down as a written pitch, which would simply be one sheet of A4. One entry that we've received so far is a handwritten, and that's absolutely fine. You could, of course, record a podcast up to 1 minute or record a short video up to 1 minute to explain your ideas. And that is then has to be emailed to us. So the correct email address is office@anyfuturesutc.co.uk. And you can put a link to your podcast or attach it, and you can attach your written pitch if you're writing it down. In the email subject, please put assistive technology competition so we know that it's your entry for the competition. And the deadline is the 3rd of March. So you've got a good period of time, including the half-term break, to get your project ideas in. Parents and carers, if your child is a bit younger, you're welcome to submit their entry on their behalf. So you can email us on their behalf. That's absolutely fine. for example, primary school age young people are welcome to enter. Now, on the 4th of March at 3 p.m, we'll be hosting our assistive technology event, and we've got some wonderful speakers, and we'll be discussing this cutting edge topic and the future of assistive technologies and innovations in healthcare. We'll also be shortlisting the best entries of the competition. So the best entries will be shortlisted and then offered further support from Accenture. And Accenture will be providing free consultancy in the real world. This will cost lots of money, so it's a great sort of prize in itself. And that consultancy will be about developing your idea into a proper business plan. And then later on in March, on the 19th of March, you will be in round two of the competition. The shortlisted entries will pitch their full business plan, and that is when the winner will be picked. So basically, you will come up with your idea ready for the 3rd of March, we'll shortlist on the 4th of March, and then we'll have the full business plans on the 19th of March and pick the overall winner of the competition. You're welcome to email us on office at nefuturesutc.co.uk if you've got any questions about our competition. I do encourage you to enter, and I look forward to seeing your entries. All the best. Take care. Bye now.